Hello everyone. My name is Franklyne Abung'ana. Welcome to my online tutorials, where I give you the insight on emerging technological issues affecting matters in education. Subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss out on my upcoming tutorials. Subscription is free. You won't be charged anything instead. You will be notified whenever I upload a new video. Welcome and keep on learning.
Welcome to part 5 of my tutorial on timetabling using the aSc Timetabling Software. Now in my previous tutorial, you are looking at how to add teachers in this very software. Will be the second last step under the generation of our timetable. Now, as you can see on my screen, we already have the skeleton of our timetable. You can clearly see the classes. We have grade 1, grade 2, and grade 3. We have the days: Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, up to Friday. And you can clearly see the periods per day. We have period 1 up to period 7. So what is missing here? It is actually the lessons. We have not yet assigned teachers lessons, therefore our timetable is basically blank. We don't have lessons. Now I'll take you through the process of assigning teachers lessons in this timetable. Now you can access teachers from this icon, as I mentioned previously, or we go through specification and then the wizard. So when you're on the wizard, you move to next until you get to the teachers. So these are subjects, these are classes, classrooms, and then teachers. This is where we were. Now there is one common thing: when you select the subjects, you can see under count we have 0000. That means you have not yet assigned teachers lessons. The same thing happens on classes. Under classes we have 00, so we don't have lessons in those particular classes. The same thing applies to classrooms. We don't have lessons. And then when you look at the teachers, you can see each teacher has 0 count as far as lessons are concerned. Now we shall be filling in or assigning teachers lessons. You'll see these numbers change. So we shall have the count of the lessons for each and every teacher. Now without much ado, let's start our exercise. Now I'll assign teacher Leviticus Koinange his lessons. So to assign the teacher lessons, select the teacher. You can see that blue selection band. So once you have selected the teacher, you now move to lessons. Click on lessons. The following dialog box will pop up, and then click on the new button. This is the new button, and click on it. And then we have that dialog box whereby we have the name of the teacher. You can still change even the teacher from that drop down, but I want us to do it systematically. And then you have the subject, we have the class, we have lessons per week. It can be a single stream or a double, triple, and what have you. You can even join classes from here. You can have more than one teacher teaching a particular lesson. So let's begin. Now, teacher Koinange Leviticus teaches grade 2. So I'll select the class here. We have grade 2. I'm going as per my subject's allocation. Now in grade 2, he teaches English. And English has a total of 3 lessons in a week. So once you do that, just click on OK. So you can see under the count, it has changed. Length, it is one lesson. Then we can assign him more lessons. We have grade 3. Click on new. Then subject, or rather class, we have grade 3. In grade 3, he teaches Kiswahili. Under the subjects, we have Kiswahili and Kiswahili. We have a total of 3 lessons in a week. Then OK. Another class, we have grade 1. In grade 1, he teaches Kiswahili. Under subjects, You have a total of 3 lessons. Then click OK. And then you have grade 3. Select on new. Class, you have grade 3. Subject, you have literacy. And for literacy, we have a total of 5 lessons per week. Then OK. Next, we have grade 1. In grade 1, teaches literacy, also a total of 5 lessons in a week. Click on OK. Next, we have grade 2. In grade 2, teaches literacy, a total of 5 lessons per week. Then finally, we have grade 1. Class grade 1. In grade 1, it also teaches literacy, a total of 5 lessons in a week. So you can see we have assigned teacher Leviticus Koinange his lessons. Once you are done, click on close. So you can see the count has changed. Now we have 29. That means teacher Leviticus has 29 lessons in a week. We repeat the same for the next teacher. This is Mseti Paul. I repeat the same and then I'll come back to you once I finish. Those are the lessons for teacher Mseti Paul. And you can still edit the lessons. Maybe you have entered a wrong lesson or extra lessons. You can select and then you remove the lesson and remove, or you can simply edit. You can edit whereby you are taken back to the dialog box as shown on my screen. Now I will close so you can see the count of the lessons for Mr. Mseti Paul. He has 21 lessons in a week. I'll do the same for the next teacher, that is Shetemi Moses. So I'll be back to you once I'm done. Good, I'm done with teacher Shetemi Moses. So I'll close. You can see his lesson count. There are 29 lessons in a week and he is a grade 1 class teacher. We shall move to our second last teacher, Jala Caleb. Click on lessons and then new. We assign him lessons. Jala Caleb teaches grade 3 English. English in grade 3. A total of 3 lessons in a week. Then you click on OK. I think that is all for that particular teacher. He has a total of 3 lessons in a week. Finally, we have Okubo Rebecca. I'll select the teacher, click on lessons, click on new. I'll assign her the subjects. We have CRA, grade 3. CRA has a total of 3 lessons. So I'll assign her all the lessons and then I'll come back to you once I'm done. Good, I'm done with subjects allocation for Kubo, Rebecca and all the teachers involved. So she has 23 lessons in a week. We can confirm that the count has also changed under classrooms. You can see we have 0 out of 35 lessons. It means my timetable is okay, because for lower classes, grade 1 to 3, you must have 35 lessons in a week. For this one, also 35 lessons in a week. And then we have the count for various subjects. English has 9 lessons in a week, Kiswahili the same, mathematics 15, environmental we are 15, hygiene we are 6, literacy 20, CRA 9, PPI 3, physical education 9, and then creative arts 9. Those lessons are okay. We go back to teachers, which is the last step, or rather the second last step on our timetable. We shall move to the next button and then we test our timetable. So I'll click on test. So you can see testing is successful. I'll click on OK. And then I'm told that classes are okay, teachers okay, subjects okay, students are also okay. I can as well test classrooms. So we are okay. Then I can now click on OK. Now start. Once I've checked all these parameters, I will now start timetable generation. Timetable step number 2, you now generate your timetable. Then okay, our timetable is now ready without any collisions. Next, we shall look at how we can change the design and also printing the timetable. Bye and see you next.
I hope you have learned something from this tutorial. If so, give this video a big thumbs up, comment, and share. Above all, subscribe to my channel and hit that bell on so that you don't miss out on my upcoming uploads. Thank you for watching. See you then.